Others also. So matrimonial, educational, as well as professional selections and every other things can be possible by astrology also. Then there is religion, then there is philosophy, then there is mysticism. Astrology gives you the guidance what to do. Religion that adds the tips of observing worships and other forms. Philosophy that justifies the principles and their impacts. Mysticism that capacitates you to perform all of these things by which we can get the benefits. So these are the various things. Religion is very common and it is very proximate to us. Religion is very proximate, but religion is mismanaged now. Religion has taught earlier that everybody should be punished. And now we are learning that God can excuse us. And religion brands something as sin. And now modern religion, it says that you can do some remedy for that. So we are thinking that God will excuse all of our sins, and for all sins there are remedies, and this is Kali Yuga. It is known as era of errata. So in this Yuga it is very common, and even if you do want to do some repentance or something, you can do after 60 years. That is known as age fixation. To go for worship or to do some repentance, we can say, just as somebody told, yes, I can eat anything, I will monitor my sugar and I will accordingly put my insulin. Like that, they are fixing one age for repentance also. I can do anything, and after 50, I totally immerse myself in remedial mechanics. So these things are the modern religious teachings. So religion is a real way. It is one among the four pillars of life management. What are the four pillars? One is music. Second is humor. Third thing is worship. Fourth thing is charity. If these three, the four things are not there, apart from religion, there are three more things. Humor means there must be a decent humor. That is not a melancholic humor, laughing on somebody's problems. So it must be a decent humor. Music and other arts, that is aesthetic taste, apart from which worship. Worship and humor, see, there are two ways for exhausting your own self. One is by crying and second is by laughing. And worship is the way through crying. And humor or taste or any other aesthetic tool, that is by means of your humor as a thing. So, by crying and laughing, one can exhaust his burdens and be in his real status. And charity is also a lightener for one's own burden. So, by maintaining this worship, charity, along with the taste in fine and performing arts, along with a decent sense of humor, is what we call real management of life. So that is what our philosophy and our other system that have taught us. And the final point is, that's why our ancestors, they contemplated more on three things. Perfection of mind, perfection of intellect, and perfection of spirit. Why they have worked for the perfection of these things rather than science and technology? Because of three reasons. One is their goal. To attain God, unless a person's mind, intellect, and spirit, they are triangularly coordinated, one cannot be emancipated at all. So it is for their goal. Number two, even for other scientific, national, social, or any other development or progress, the base is a perfect mind, a sharp intellect, and a sound spirit, without which one cannot rejoice. Even if the rejoicement is there, that will be ephemeral. That cannot be all-round development, that cannot be permanent development at all. So serving as a base for other developments, we have mentioned that. So one is as a goal, second is as a base for other developments, third is considering the future. They understood that after thousands of years, at the era of Kali, at the advent of Kali, people will be totally lost from the pathway. They will be deviated from the arbitrary adhesion. Due to this, they will require some strong tool for mind precision, intellectual sharpening, and spiritual radiation. So considering our future also, they have given all of these things. So we have to make a syllabus and impart that knowledge to all of the other people. And there are five major hurdles due to which we cannot get into the benefit at all. Five major hurdles with our own self. One is, we are always saying one excuse, that is known as excuse of innocence. I have not studied this book. I do not know this thing. How you learnt Espanol, Chinese, German, English and other languages? How do you know about computer and typewriting? See, whenever you have understood that it is going to be fruitful for you, whenever it is going to fetch you dollars and currencies, then immediately you have voluntarily subjected towards learning of operation skills, linguistic skills and communication skills. Likewise, if you want to live, the excuse of innocence is inexcusable. So, number one, the first problem with us is the excuse of innocence. And number two is inceptive negligence. Whenever your problem is starting in the small level, this LTTE, Osama Bin Laden, they started at a very small level, like a very grocery, small grocery shop. Now they are in a super complex model. When they started a small grocery shop, Most of the people they supported, most of the people were mute spectators, now they are reaping the harvest. So negligence in the incentive level is our second problem. That also we have to totally this thing, totally we have to eradicate that thing. The third thing is double hold. We want to take the cough expectorant and also the ice cream. It is very impossible. Without sacrificing or without relinquishing the unwanted element inside you, no temple, no ritual or no receptor can purify. There is a possibility of you to impurify those status. That is a real possible thing that may happen. So it is known as double grip. Fourth thing is blind jump. Without knowing how we can do, immediately we jump into this. Tomorrow, somebody told me, I am in deep trouble. I asked, what is the trouble? He told, I have fixed the marriage next month and I have to spend 20 lakhs. Well, we are fixing, you know the fact that you have to spend 20 lakhs. Then why you have done that? I don't know, this is the only daughter I have to do, somehow I have to do that. I am having some tension, what is the relief? No, there is no relief at all, it is blind jump. And the fifth thing is predetermination. You have already determined something in your mind, already you are full, and we cannot re-pour or we cannot add anything to that. So these five problems are there with these people. The first thing is excuse of innocence, and second thing is inceptive negligence, third thing is blind jump, fourth thing is double hold, fifth thing is predetermination. Unless you people are ready to totally uproot all of these unwanted elements inside you, the divine nectar, the preceptorial gracious nectar cannot fulfill your demands, cannot fill your heart, cannot fill your spirit, and you cannot get the benefit at all. Considering this as an introduction to life management, I wish that somehow somebody should someday take a decision to frame a syllabus, perfect syllabus with the workshop methodologies, so that the life management can be taught to our people and transmitted to other parts of the world. I have already told, once again, India should take the global leadership, not by invasion, not by cultural infusion, but by its benevolent embrace of giving knowledge, support and love to the members of the globe. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.